Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Acton and I welcome you to the monthly Poetry Appreciation Society meeting. Today it seems that we have, well, let's say, only a few poets and singers. It seems that this will be a rather small gathering. But we will see, we will see. It's still not officially started. I hope you enjoy and stay awesome, because that is what you truly are. Welcome to the 120th meeting ever in Stonewind, and I suppose now also Dalaran Poetry Appreciation Society meeting. I think it's 19, but I will leave that to Bertle. The sound is on and I can speak. As usual, I will start out by reciting a poem, then other poets might take turn reciting their poetry or eventual singing a song according to the sign-up list. If anyone forgot to sign up, you will figure it out after the ones of the list have performed. As always, the meeting will conclude with a small firework display. So, first poem of tonight's meeting was written by someone who signs themselves as Xuanshun Xuanwu. I'm sorry if I butchered the name, but I don't speak any Asian language. and it is titled Footprints in the Sand. Yours. Footprints in the sand. Your pale round face on which I glare, bewitched by heaven's gleam. Moonbeams lit your golden hair. My love, my life, this dream. Gently dancing, one with the ocean. Footprints in the sand. Take my hands. My love. My maiden fair, take my hands, and as I so dance through the night, the sun arose and daylight broke. Her pale face fading. Lifeless, drifting apart, dissolved by the same self-ocean breeze. that brought her presence back to life. In my memory, that was super. It's amazing. So, next poet on this improvised stage will be Rustain. Oh shit. I'm afraid. I'm in danger.
I'm in danger.
Give her a proper applaud, of course. I have now a proper good chair, so I'm sitting comfortably while reading out these poetries. It feels super nice. Last month's poetry, I still have to recapture it. I was super discouraged because how I screwed up. So, I'm sorry about that. I will catch up as soon as possible. I'm back to my positive self, except for the fear that I have in my body. You know. Ha! Good times once more! I've been missing some months, for I had been sent to hell. A mind-blowing place. Oh, really? I can begin. Anyway, one could say hell is hot, you know. Oh wait, that's actually summer. Jesus fucking Christ. I've been lately walking around without a shirt. I've been a real life octolon. Beyond the veil. Endless realms of ages old, shards of souls and lost lives. Our spirits shan't be easily sold, yet he who of slavery thrives won't surrender his ancient war. Oh, do we get a Shadowlands poem from Miss Rustain? Is her character actually traveling there? Cycle of five, cycle of images. Order, renewal, sin, battles, last in hell. Last is hell, where the jailer hides, no peace in his infernal forges. A prisoner himself, in its heat, heart of black star. What the fuck, Octolon? In its heart of bleak star, armies clash of blackened steel, beneath lightless skies. Spin of faith, the wheel toward a new land, the blood cries. In his ancient castle, the sire dwells. Yep, yep, totally. Totally is Shadowlands. Ruler of sinful soil, water, air, in elegant clothes and refined manners. King of nobles, nested in their high lair, lords and ladies of war, faith, politics, slavers and sinners. To be honest, it sounds like a fucking lore lesson. But maybe not. There, far away, an isle of miserable courage. How narrow is their sight. In life, it was an obsession. Beyond any reason, a lie, a mirage. True pain and death on the bloodiest battlefield can save no one might. Now order, golden golden bright, purest waters, and infinite wings, renouncing entirely to oneself is absolute freedom. For when the minds are tied to obscure acts, the torment has no room. No room there actually. First the forest lush sung by a white queen of winter. All around in dusk mild, nature takes its times. The silver play, work I hunt, Tyrnen observes silently. Wardens of cycle, life ends and life is renewed in such gleaming wild, and events go as they are meant to, all across the Tyrnas sound joyfully. Here I end to voice what I have seen, beyond reality, beyond the veil. Oh, nice. Now I get it. Now I get it. Next part will be my jaw started to hurt. Kaldrick. Ladies and gentlemen, give a warm welcome for Mr. Kaldrick Donnell. Over here. Brought my harp along again. Ooh, how are we gonna get a play on the harp? That is the... Fuck me, I'm yawning like a bitch again. That is a good question now. Thank you, Bertel. I have modification of the traditional sailor's jig, which I have set to harp. I call it the distant dawn. Oh, as long as there are no words, I'm fine with that. Oh shit, there are birds. Sails on the ocean breeze, sails on the salty seas, spray open the sailor's mind, what new lands will he find? Sail on, brave sailor, sail on, into the distant dawn. A dance and a song upon the deck. Stay from booze unless you wreck the ship which you steer. A heavy curse is upon your beer. Sail on, brave sailor, sail on into the distant dawn. From Kultiras to Lordeon, harshest storms will be drawn, but cheer sets the waves at ease. Women wailing, but at ease. Sail on, brave sailor, sail on into the distant dawn. Three merry roars from the men. They will be back, but who knows when? Until then, fresh adventures await on high seas and every strait. Sail on, brave sailor, sail on into the distant dawn. Come on, what the fuck is wrong with those tongue twists? I mean, that was, it was good. It was magnificent.
But my tongue is not taking it lightly.
You smart. You very smart. We the best. You a genius.
Next up, Felicia. The warden of the bar. Whew. I'm quite curious what she brought this time. I need to see for myself. No title for this, just something I mused one night. Alright, alright. Standing under the monster's night, the bee to be one battled with a soothing light. They come lurking as doubts and fears, only to retreat as the sunlight nears. We all worry on that we miss to lose our footing, fall to the abyss. Maybe that is why we choose to sleep, rather than facing those that make us weep. The good and bad, the black and white, divine and demonic, as day and night. We praise one and we avoid another, the other. Much like the concurrence, you never quite smother. It's hard to peace, hard to think, as the lines of reason drain down the stained thing. Why is one to like, the other is not? They simply exist like life and a rot. Reading it back, I lose my place. I'm left stunned, as if struck by a maze. Where was I going? I don't know. I only go where the words seem to go. Lost in the dark, they are my only lead of this hapless shell, hapless, on which the darkness may feed. Okay. That was medium difficulty.
Next up is Father Devin Lightstick.
May I ask you, Father? Leave the kids alone, yeah? Especially the boys.
Stay, applause. No, no, no. Oh, no, 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 no. This could be really difficult for me. No. I am scared. Shit.
And for some reason I'm also tired, but
the fact that he doesn't say anything for so long. It is not a poem, I shall recite, but words write by myself and my brother. Brother Galasar, long missing, in careful deliberation. Okay. Hope it's not about children.
As darkness rends light, such must light rend darkness, rend light, lest they both be in vain. For if one consumes the other, all is for naught.
Oh, I like that.
A battle considered won is a battle considered lost, for only the victor claims a tale of presumed glory. True. Oh, it was short.
I'm fairly not satisfied.
It was too short, yet beautiful. So, since we are not as many as usual, I will recite another poem before the next person on the list gets their turn. It was written by my good friend Pip, who promised she would do her best to be there for the meeting next month and recite a brand new poem for offerers. This one is an older one, though. I believe I remember Pip. Titled The Fairy. Ooh, fairies. Fairies. Leafy spiral all unfurled. Unfurled? Bright beetle winged. Alight she. On this green veined hand. Pardon me. Her weightless grace. Plain occupies my tiny world, and by her humming song, my heart, she causes to expand. Okay, that was short and nice. It surely will suffice.
What do? You get another brilliant idea.
Next up is here in Ice Paws. There once was a Trog unlike any other. Why? His intellect surprised even his mother. Tired of other Trogs, he put on a hat and a guise and left his home to find quite a surprise. For at Ironforge Gate he would find his fate, when all the dwarves complimented his hat and his beard, and the Trog no longer felt like he stood out so weird. Where he so quietly stood rather a fool, he thought a tale for these dwarves I must pull. But when he blissfully opened his mouth, the dwarf said, "This is a Trog, no mere lout." And so the dwarves put his body with a spike throughout, for it is better to be thought a fool than to speak up and move all doubt. Wow, that was good and fast. Well, that was because I was late.
Oh, tears! Oh! Okay!
Oh my fucking god, that's genius!
The list says it's Nicholas' turn to recite a poem now, or perhaps sing a song. Oh, that's me. Where are you, Nicholas? Nicholas Cage. There we have him. Nicholas Larkspur. Well, come up here then and share what you got with us. Yeah, don't be shy. You are not being judged or anything. It's not a competition. No, it's not. It's not. This is a little song. Oh shit. I wrote about the Nordgate Rebellion in Kilnaeus. This is little more than a doggerel in truth, but one I hope you will enjoy and take heed of all the same.
Well, fuck. Often, it is said that pride comes before a fall, but was it pride or fear that made Greymane build the wall? He locked us from the world and threw away the key, said, "Don't you worry, you will be safe in here with me." Uh-oh, oh no, oh no. Your parents live in Pyrewood? Well, best bid them goodbye, for their lands will be cut off and then slowly left to die. "Hush now," said the king. "Please do not scream and bawl. You will see them on the other side, no? I do not mean the wall." "No, no. Godfrey is certainly no better. A money grabber and a cutthroat. Are we sure he is not just two goblins tucked in a long coat?" Crowley defied the tyrant, and he is lucky, with plenty good reason, showered leadership and bravery, and they called it bloody treason. In the night they killed the baker's son, as a stern warning, yet the nobles still expect their fresh bread in the morning. The fuck? Outside a cold wind blows. Don your cloaks and hoods. Do not stray from the path. There is howling in the woods. Oh, dear king, you cannot close your eyes and hope it will disappear, for your past mistakes will soon come back and bite you in the rear. I'm gonna say it as it is. Bite you in the ass. Okay, good, good, good. Good thing I don't sing, so I could manage it. So, now the turn has come to Zack, who I believe got an announcement too. Oi, oi, oi. This could be another naughty one. Let's do the announcement first. For the regulars, it should come as no surprise by now. Of course not, Zack. Of course not. Tonight at 11, starting at the Golden Cake, I'm hosting the Murder Walk. Scary skeletons and shivers down your spine. Shrieking skulls will shock your soul, seal your doom tonight. Spooky, scary skeletons speak with such a screech. You'll shake and shudder in surprise when you hear these zombies shriek. A trip around the city where I tell gruesome, horrific stories. It's free and lasts 30 to 40 minutes. Proper scary. That over with, a little poem, just to make sure Bertel dies, a little inside. Oh shit.
Oh. No.
Oh, it's time for a naughty one. Stroke me tender, along with every single inch. Lick and caress me, baby. Feel that pinch. Let's get lost in this sensuous haze. Fluffy feelings that keep us dazed. Moving in rhythm, neither of us can speak. Until after we hit that incredible peak. Damn you, damn you. Seems like we already reached the end of the list with another poem by Rostain. Oh shit, I'm in danger again. Twice a day? That's a lot. But I will add a closing poem after that, since we got a little time left. Or if anyone forgot to sign up, you will get a chance. Anyway, give a warm welcome for Rustane. Or one of my classics. Oh, good, at least it's not Burning Crusade.
I'm in danger!
So long, Rose of Stormwind. Your horse of white saw disagreement.
I think she's typing it.
Sung in secrets of voice and mind, crows. Crows spoke in unison their lament. The story of all dead wounds open. A raging memory is what they left.
Good point, Mr. Point, Father. It does seem like it's about the Defiers.
Anger makes union among weak men. Reason has no space. A mob bereft. Death has two faces, both unclear. Who can tell if of a friend or a cruel foe? Be by secret hand your fate, O dear, sanctioned in blood, pain and woe. So long, Rose of Stormwind, your stone of white chance torment.
Yep, that's definitely the fires.
Good guess, Father Lightstick?
Yes, Lightstick.
Since there is no others, the closing one, the closing poem of today is done by Bertel again, and it was once again by Pip as the author. So I expect a lot of tongue twistery. After that, I will go prepare for a small firework display. It's quite spooky how small the attendance was today. I would expect actually far more because it's a Stormwindian poetry meeting. There are usually people around like masses. Thanks to everyone attending the meeting. Special thanks to everyone who contributed as well.
Of course. I did not contribute.
This time I had nothing. Well, I do have one, but I'm still working with that. Next meeting will be Friday, the 9th of July, this time in Dalaran, usual time. And I won't be speaking that, I will be there, I will be recording it. However, I won't have a mouth to speak with. Well, teeth, so, you know. Quite nervous about it. Anyway, here comes the poem. Titled Spider. Oh shit. Spider-Man, Spider-Man. By my good friend Pip. There is a spider on my chair. He thinks he is the lord of it. Mashed, Harvey in will and glare. He wins in legs. I win in wit. Only with this leaf and glass do I assert my dominance. He will return in 2 days hence, and we will again replay this dance. Okay, that was a good one, I admit. I expected some gruesome fight between a spider and a gnome.
You're so funny.
Yeah, you know.
Awesome, very sexy fun.
Yeah. Well, I thank you for watching, and I hope you like this month's poetry. Even though it was a small attendance and small contribution as well, but I still think they were good and worth it. Just like Miss Ice Paul said, a lot of interesting poems tonight. Was fun. Indeed, indeed. Stay awesome, because that is what you truly are. Actelon, peace out.